Hey friends, welcome back. Kara Corey here, and for today's video, we are going to go through the Buffbunny collection launch. It's the hint of summer launch. It's not their full-on summer collection, just thrown in just like a little sprinkle of it. So for those of you who were saying the last launch, which was swimwear, some of you voiced that you were really looking forward to some new athletic pieces launching. Here it is. Here it is for you. All wrapped up into four brand new pieces for you guys. These are really good pieces. I'm super excited to review them for you. So we're gonna go through all four items in details. I took your questions on IG, so I'm gonna give you as much detail as possible for those of you that are interested in shopping. Before we hop right into the review, I do wanna mention to make sure you are subscribed to the channel, hit the like button if you do enjoy these reviews, and make sure that you have that post notification bell on. With that being said, this launch is happening June 6th, which is this upcoming Saturday. For those of you who are watching this ahead of time, the actual time for the launch hasn't been announced yet. I'm gonna assume it's the same standard times, which is typically 1 p.m. Central Standard Time. I'm on Eastern Standard Time, so it's 2 p.m. for those of us here on my side of the world. But if that does change, I will update you guys in the comments section and I'll pin that so that you are well aware. You guys can join me here live on the YouTubes on June 6th. It's a Saturday. I go ahead and I do a live 1 hour before the launch. That way I can just kind of hang out with you guys, answer any questions, I try on pieces. Sometimes I have more information at that time about pricing, if it's worth it, and any other details I may know that transpire from now till then, I can update you guys. And honestly, I have so much fun on the lives, and you guys tell me you really have a lot of fun with them too. So even if you're not shopping, but you just kind of want to come hang out with me, I will be here next Saturday, most likely at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And before I forget, because I will, my last little call out, you guys can choose to support me if you do plan on shopping. If you don't, there's always no pressure on my end. The world is weird right now. If you are not able to shop, you can't shop, no pressure from me. If you are planning on shopping though, and you enjoy my videos and you enjoy the time I take to give you these detailed reviews, you can support me back by throwing Kara in the support code box they now have, or if you forget that, you have the opportunity to enter into the discount code box. It does not give you a discount, but it does earn me a small commission and it helps me grow with the brand. Regardless of being affiliated, I do like to mention I give you guys as honest of a review as possible. That is what I am here to do. I'm not gonna BS you. I know you guys are BS proof.
I understand. How are we BSing you?
Exactly. I'm BS proof.
As am I, so we're not even gonna go there. I'm gonna spill you the truth on this collection. So let's jump right in. Nothing says a hint of summer like a Diet Pepsi. So there's some similarities amongst all four pieces launching, so I'm gonna do one call out for that, and that is that all four pieces are made with the energy fabric. They launched the energy fabric last summer for the summer collection. It came out in a few different pieces that were available. I have a couple here just to share with you. One of them was the Live Capri. This came out in several different colors. This was the Hawaiian color. There was also the spicy bra. I have that to match those capris. And then the spicy leggings. Those were the leggings that also had the mesh that ran up the calf. The fabric on those was the energy fabric. It is one of Buffbunny's best fabrics, if not the best fabric that they've come out with. So I am so happy to see that they finally have brought it out again in more pieces for you guys. So every item launching, the sports bra, the shorts, the crop top, and the leggings are all in the energy fabric. So we'll jump right into the leggings. These are the Live leggings, and I'm wearing them right here right now in the color Onyx, which is black, and then I'm also showing them to you in this beautiful blue color. It's called Bondi Blue. I really love this color, and I want to say this is kind of the lightest color that you can get in the leggings or in this collection altogether. So I was really happy I got this color, not because it was just beautiful, which it is, but also so that I could review it in terms of the concerns when we wear a lighter color legging or shorts. Is there any kind of see-through ability there? is the cottage cheese coming out? You guys need to know. So I was very happy to get this color. Very, very beautiful. The energy fabric, before we dive right fully into the leggings, a lot of people want to know, what is it comparable to, or what is it most similar to? What are the differences between the energy and the Nubry, which is in the Rosa leggings? So comparatively, they are very similar at first touch. You feel like, is this the same material? But it's not. You will quickly notice when you put these on, there is something so different about them. The stretchiness to them, and almost, it feels almost like an additional compression, if you will, or like a little bit more of a thickness. And the major difference here in the material, they are made of nylon and spandex, which is similar to the Rosa legging or the Nubry fabric. However, your energy fabric has just a teens more spandex in it, a little less nylon, which is what kind of aids in that extra stretchability, if you will. And they also made these with the fabric's made with what they call the four-way stretch to it. So it's just super duper stretchy. And the Rosa leggings are as well. The energy fabric just has like a little bit more, just a little bit more thicker feeling. It feels like it holds you in a little bit more, whereas the Rosa leggings don't necessarily. They're a very naked feel. These are a very buttery naked feel, but they do add a little bit. It gives you that little bit of support where you need it. So they are super duper comfortable, buttery, silky smooth, just the way you like it, but with that massive stretchiness that just provides just such a high level of comfort. For any type of activity, these are something I would wear for any kind of activity or sport, but also just to lifestyle in, just to wear around the house in my everyday life, because if you can't fashion a legging, then I don't want to be a part of society. Another call out across the board, because I do forget, I am wearing a size small in all pieces I'm sharing with you guys today for reference. Size small in every single item, and I will leave for you guys my measurements in the description box so that you can check it out there. Or if you're new to shopping Buffbunny collection, I have loads of other videos you can go through, kind of watch, see how pieces fit me, and that'll just help you make better decisions about how pieces may fit you. But they also do have a nice size guide up on their website for reference if you're curious about sports bras, things like that, if you've never shopped this brand before. One of the biggest questions I get with any pair of leggings is, will I be able to see cellulite through the leggings? Now, honestly, this is the lightest color you can get. You're gonna see some footage where I am squeezing my glutes a little bit. I did the squat test trying to squeeze my glutes. You're gonna see me kind of jumping up and down in these a little bit. I feel like maybe if you're looking really hard for it while I'm squeezing and actually flexing my glutes, you may be able to see a little bit there, but not really. These are not a legging you're gonna walk around in and really see cottage cheese moving and grooving. It's always gonna be up to your own personal comfort level. No, I have some cellulite on the back of my thighs. It doesn't make a huge difference to me. I don't think this material is thin where it's really aggressively in your face. Other colors available for the Live leggings, I've got here, like I said, the Bondi blue. I'm wearing Onyx or the black. Also available in Starry Night, which is a navy blue color. I've got here in the shorts. And then Bora Bora, which is a teal color. Other details on this, on these leggings to know, another difference here between these and the Rosa leggings, their seam goes straight all the way across in the back. And with the energy fabric, any of their items made with the energy fabric, even the spicy leggings and the capris, they've been designed with a bit more of a contour in the booty section. So it kind of contours down at a V, and it does kind of enhance and make the booty look a little bit more plump, if you will. So that design is just kind of, it's a subtle change, but it's quite a significant change in terms of how it looks and fits. The waistband itself, this is something I like to measure because I'm a bit of a snob when it comes to my high-waisted leggings. I like to make sure, are they high-waisted enough? I get asked that a lot. Why I put that in quotes, I'm not sure. Sometimes it just feels right to put stuff in quotes. I don't know why. Moving on, the actual waistband measured is 4 inches high. That's kind of my sweet spot. I like it to be 4 inches. If it's less than 4 inches, It's too small, you know? That's what she said. In terms of camel toe, you guys talk about this a lot. We have the crotch gusset, if you will, is that long oval shape. I know sometimes that bothers people because it kind of comes down a little bit on the sides. Sometimes you can see that if you're like spreading your leg open, but I don't mind it. I like it to be a little bit longer than smaller. I really didn't feel like I had crazy camel toe that couldn't be avoided in these, especially in the darker colors. Darker colors, you can't notice a thing. You will see the footage where I'm outdoors that I am wearing a seamless underwear underneath. I wanted to wear those so you guys could kind of see how it looks. You can kind of see the seamless underwear a little bit if they're not like perfectly like smoothed out, which I feel like my seamless underwear, I love that they're seamless, but they always end up moving on me because they're so silky smooth and seamless. So it's kind of like a double-edged sword. In the footage you're seeing of me wearing them here in this room, I am not wearing underwear with them, so you can kind of get a little bit of the differences with how it looks. I personally prefer to wear a legging like this with no underwear, but what I will do is add like a panty liner in there, like just one of those little ones, and that can also help with any level of camel toe if you're worried about it. But these are a win for me in terms of camel toe. I don't think they're bad. I think the capris, for whatever reason, gave me more camel toe. Like that was like a guaranteed toe and not so much with the leggings. And the inseam on the leggings, which is measuring from the crotch gusset all the way down to your ankle, is about 26 inches. So for me, these really kind of hit me perfect in the ankle. You'll notice I didn't have a ton of extra fabric there. I do have shorter legs. I am a short person. And then I feel like in terms of my body, I just have relatively short legs. So I think if you are a taller person or you tend to have longer legs, you may find maybe they will run a little bit short. Maybe they'll come more of a 7/8 inch on you. I'm not certain. There is just like that littlest bit of fabric left on me. I really like where they hit me. So if you are short-legged, then you may love these leggings for that reason. There isn't all that bunching of the extra material down at the bottom. Okay, let's move on next to the shorts, which I feel like you guys and myself included were most excited about. They came out with the Live Short, and I have the beautiful color Starry Night, which is that navy blue. It may pick up a touch purple on the camera, I'm not sure, but we've got the Starry Blue, and then this is the color Passion, which is more of like a deeper, darker pink color, which is really, really pretty. Also same as the top I'm wearing. Now the Live Shorts, obviously energy fabric. They are super comfortable. I was kind of curious how these were gonna fit, and they are like my perfect summer short. I absolutely loved the performance shorts that Buffbunny came out with previously, and I think I'm gonna be wearing these and reaching for them all summer long. Reason being is the length on them for me personally is really perfect. So it's really important for me with a short that they're not too short, that they're not too short and that they're not too tight in the actual seaming where it hits you on the thighs. Now I am someone where I carry the majority of my weight, and anytime I gain weight, and your girl has gained a couple pounds in quarantine, this stuff, it all goes to my booty cheeks. I ain't mad about that, but it also goes to my inner thighs. That is just where those fat cells, they get bigger there, okay? And that's fine. But that's where, for me, I'm a bit more particular with my shorts and how they fit so that I still feel confident, because I'm just someone who is adamant, regardless of how I'm feeling about myself, I am gonna wear shorts and I'm gonna feel good about it in the summertime. So I was really, really happy with how these shorts fit and feel. Obviously, I'm a fan of the energy fabric, so loving the leggings as much as I do, it was no surprise that I was also going to love the shorts. Important things to know on the shorts: the inseam, which is really important for most of us. So from the crotch down to the bottom of the short is 5 inches. Again, anything less than that makes me a little bit uncomfortable. It's a little bit too short. The top band also has that 4-inch band up top, and you'll also notice that contour detailing on the back side of the shorts. The total length on the shorts themselves, I've got the size small, from the top of the waistband down to the bottom of the short is 13.5 inches. The biggest question I get with shorts, and a question I have too, is how bad do they ride up? No one wants to be wearing shorts and picking and pulling down the entire time, because it just doesn't look so ladylike, am I right? And it's also quite annoying. I did not find that I was pulling these down much, if at all. I will say, I think it's impossible if you're doing like a high intense workout, if you're doing jump squats, burpees, going for a run, the likelihood of you not having any kind of ride up is probably impossible with any short, any fabric, any material. I did work out in these today doing a back workout, and you know, I didn't do any cardio mixed in, but just walking around doing the back workout, I did not have any issues with them riding up or needing to pull or maneuver anything. I did do a little bit of cardio in this. I did some jump squats, you know, a little bit more HIIT style to test it out, and I felt like there was a little bit of it slipping up, but not much at all. You'll notice I did some running in place just to demonstrate it for you guys. The amount of the ride up is really, it doesn't ride up much at all. So these are a short that I can go for a run in. I believe they have the same length as the performance shorts, and I wear those all the time for running. They do not bother me. They don't ride all the way up where they just keep inching up and then half your butt cheeks are showing to the world. They do really stay relatively well in place. So that is a huge win. Thank you, Buffbunny Collection and the whole team, for making a short for us ladies that don't ride up. And what I like about the fabric with these on these shorts, you will notice I have maybe a little bit of sausaging, I like to call it. That's a technical term for when the fat kind of pokes over if something is too tight on you, if the seam is too tight. I felt pretty comfortable in these and how they looked. I felt very confident in them. I think a size down, if I went to an extra small, they'd be too tight for me, but the size small was perfect, and I felt really good about how they hugged my thighs. And again, I have relatively thicker thighs for being the size that I am, so these were pretty much my perfect summer short, I'm not gonna lie. I think this maybe is my number one pick out of this launch. Colors available in the shorts are Passion, then Onyx, which is black, the Bondi Blue, which is the light blue, Bora Bora, which is teal, and the Starry Night, which is dark blue. And these are gonna be available in sizes extra small to extra large. I failed to mention in the leggings, they will be available in extra small all the way up to triple XL. The next piece we're gonna talk about is the Lively Bra, and that is, I'm wearing it right now. I just wanna flash you guys. I'm wearing it right now in the Stormy Night color, and then I also have it. It comes in this white color, which is called Coconut, which I love because it just reminds you of summer. The bra is gonna be available in size extra small all the way up to triple XL, available in Onyx, Starry Night, Coconut, and Bondi Blue. I feel like this is a very unique sports bra. I've really not seen anything else like it. It's got almost like this choker situation up top with kind of like a strappy, caged type strap detailing on the bra. It's almost like I look at it and I'm like, there's a lot going on here. How am I gonna get into that? That looks stressful and difficult. And it's actually not. You've got this metal reinforced clasp up top that comes undone, and you very easily slip this overhead. I was a foolio at first and I didn't realize that came undone, so I was trying to like squeeze my fat head through there, which is why I got self-tanner all over it. But yes, that comes undone and very easily slides right on with that nice metal clasp back there. Now, I'm usually in between sizes on sports bras. I possibly could have sized down in the sports bra to an extra small because I feel like this sports bra is really good for large-chested ladies, if you will. I don't know that it's as flattering on me personally. I still enjoy the sports bra, I still like it, but it doesn't really do much for me with all that detailing. I do feel like it just is kind of more flattering for someone with a larger chest. Nonetheless, though, I wanted to put it to the test, and I was interested in how this would feel and wear. If it was going to be like annoying with like the choker piece up here, if it was just with all the straps going to be bothersome. And honestly, it was funny because I wore it to go out and get photos with Jason, and then it was like 9:30 at night. We're sitting on the couch watching the Michael Jordan documentary, and I'm like, oh yeah, I'm wearing a sports bra right now. I should probably get out of my Buffbunny clothes and actually put on, you know, normal pajamas. But that's how comfortable it is. Like, I don't feel like I'm even wearing a sports bra right now, which is nice, especially with that choker piece. Now, had I have sized down to an extra small, maybe that would have been tighter and not as comfortable. But honestly, I was very impressed with the comfort level of this sports bra. I was also impressed with the fact that it does prove to be medium to high support. So whether you have smaller or big ladies, I think this is really a great medium to high support bra for you. I did a lot of high intense cardio, jumping around, moving around, running up and down stairs, and had absolutely no issues with feeling very supported in this sports bra. And, you know, with the amount of strappiness on it and the metal reinforcement back there, I thought something was gonna kind of feel uncomfortable or pinchy or scratchy, and absolutely nothing did. So this is made with your energy fabric, so it is super buttery, creamy, feels soft against the skin, and does not lend itself to any kind of irritation. And is it just me, but this sports bra definitely gives me like Britney Spears-esque type vibes. Like, I feel like I'm channeling my inner Britney Spears wearing it, and that makes me really happy. The last piece we're gonna review is the Live crop top, which I'm wearing right now in the color Passion. It's gonna be available in Onyx, Bondi Blue, and Bora Bora, and it will be available in extra small up into size large. This is just a super simple kind of basic piece that really could flatter any kind of outfit. Like, I wouldn't just wear it working out. I feel like this little crop top would look great with the girl boss skirt. It would look really cute with a pair of jeans or a pair of shorts for the summertime. So if you're someone who's looking for something that can be worn multiple different ways, I think this is the piece for you. What's really nice about it is, again, with the energy fabric, really soft and creamy. It's got a nice neckline, which isn't like too high or too low. It fits very nice. It does have kind of the shorter sleeves, which I usually like in the summertime. And the other thing folks asked was about the breathability and kind of sweating with this type of material. And honestly, with this fabric, I was wearing this yesterday for a shirt like this that it is just right sitting there in my armpit. I was running around, I was getting hot, my armpits were sweaty. I took the shirt off, you could only see like a faint little bit of moisture, wetness, if you will. I've worn, you know, when you wear like a cotton shirt and all of a sudden you got sweat all the way down to your waistline. Anybody else? I am a sweaty, sweaty person, so it is important for me, especially with a top of this nature, that the fabric is very breathable, which you will find with the energy fabric. Will you get a little bit of sweat marks? Yes, but it's gonna be more faint, and it's also gonna go away much quicker than other materials, so the dry down time is relatively quick. This top is really beautiful too. It's kind of got the rounded bottom, and it's a little bit of a high to low. It comes down a little bit lower on the backside, scoops up on the inside a little bit, and just sits really nice. It sits for me like right, probably like 2 inches, maybe an inch and a half above my belly button, and then comes down a little bit longer in the back. So if you're someone that doesn't want to show that much of your stomach, wearing the Live leggings or the Live shorts with them, as you can see right now, I'm wearing both. You don't really show that much stomach, so it's a nice way to be able to wear a crop top. There I go, quoting things again. It's a nice way to wear a crop top without feeling like everything's on display and you're exposed. All right, guys, that is the entire Hint of Summer Buffbunny collection launch. I did love every piece. I would honestly say for me personally, my number one pick from this assortment, if you had to only pick one, would be the shorts. If you're not a shorts person, then obviously the leggings would be my next pick. But I really, really love the shorts. They're super comfortable. I'm gonna wear them for bike rides. I'm gonna wear them for going for runs, hiking, and just, you know, spending a day outside in the summertime. And I would say my number two would then be the crop top, just because I feel like it is so versatile and you can pair it with a lot of different items, whether it's for workout or for just a summer outfit. And just being honest, I would say for me, the sports bra, for me personally would be a pass. I'm just more kind of drawn to like a basic sports bra or something that just flatters my chest size a little bit better, but it is a great sports bra in terms of that medium to high support, and I think it would really flatter a larger chested lady. I myself will probably be going back in to buy myself another pair of leggings, shorts, and a crop top because this may be my favorite fabric. Now that I've tried it in more pieces, before it was only in a couple, now that I really feel it in a legging on its own without the mesh, I think for me these may trump the roses. I'm just saying. I really feel like they just, because they have that little bit more compression to them, I do feel like they're a bit more flattering than the Rosa leggings. So I don't want to miss out on getting some other colors because the leggings seem to go really, really quick. And that was my best attempt at a short, concise review for you guys. You guys said you really quite enjoy how detailed and thorough I am. I get a touch rambly, but I try to be as thorough as possible and think about any questions you guys may have. If I've missed anything, as I'm sure I have, feel free to comment below, and I do a pretty good job at responding back to each and every one of you. You guys can also, please, I encourage you to join me for the live on June 6th around 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. That way I can update you on any other information I have for what's launching at this time. I do believe it's only these four pieces. I'm not aware of any other restocks or things of that nature, and I also don't know pricing as of yet. So any other information I get, I will share with you on the live. And yeah, that's gonna be it. I hope you guys enjoyed this review video and are as excited as I am about these pieces. So please feel free to leave a comment, question below. I love you all so much. Don't forget to plug in code Kara if you are planning on shopping, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.